Well, we have some good news coming in from Belgrade at the Serbia Open 2021. After four rounds, Pranav V, who's untitled, has a rating of 2366, is on 3.5 out of 4. And just have a look at his performance. You know, in the fourth round, he beat a very, very strong Serbian GM named Milos Perunovic, who is a very good player, well known. This is Pranav's performance right now. You can see that he is on 3.5 out of 4. He has a performance of 2780. And also, he has managed to cross the 2400 ELO barrier. Now, how cool is that? Because in order to become an IM, you need four criteria. You need 3 IM norms and you need to cross 2400. Pranav has 2 IM norms already. And now he has crossed 2400 for the first time in his life. Also, he will now have great chances of making an IM norm here, thereby completing his IM title. He could also make a GM norm though, when he gets the IM plus a GM norm, if he performs over 2600. But we'll see how the tournament goes. It's still a long way ahead. But the good news for all of us is that the June membership that we collected on Chessbase India has enabled Pranav to go and play there, and he is performing tremendously. So a big thanks to everyone who contributed and became a member. So let's go and check out this game. This is Pranav versus Perunovic. Oh, by the way, I had to show a very nice picture to you, which is this one. This is taken by Rupali. Pranav on the right, Arjun on the left. And I feel like players, when they play next to each other in over the board tournaments from the same country in an international tournament, they feel some kind of, you know, unity, support, and so on. Okay, so time to go to the game, and let's see how Pranav managed to beat such a strong GM with the black pieces. So Perunovic opened the game with 1e4. Pranav went e5 in the game. Knight to f3, knight c6, bishop b5, it's the Ruy Lopez, a6, bishop a4, knight f6, all standard stuff. And now knight to c3. Now, I have been usually telling that, you know, in the Ruy Lopez or even in the Italian, you shouldn't put your knight on c3. You should try to put the pawn here, then eventually go d4. The knight usually comes to d2. But knight c3 is a possible move, and he played it. b5 by Pranav here. Bishop b3, and now he develops his bishop to c5, which is the most natural and active square. Now, you should know that Pranav is a very aggressive player. He likes to play attacking and aggressive chess, so this is a natural move for him. Knight to d5, it makes sense because, you know, now you want to play c3 later on, so you free up that square. By the way, winning this pawn is not really a possibility. White has a good move here, which is d4. And it doesn't really work out. Let's say you take e takes d4, then after castles and rook e1, already black is facing a lot of troubles, because if he goes back to f6, then this pin is very, very irritating, and also the knight doesn't have good squares. So these are some of the ideas in this opening with knight c3 and d5. And Pranav was aware of it, so he didn't fall for it. He just played the move d6, solid chess. c3 was played. Once again, taking on e4 comes with its share of danger with d4. So Pranav here played an important move, which is h6. Because now after d4, he could drop back his bishop, and there is no pin with bishop g5. Knight takes f6. Queen took on f6, and now bishop to d5. Pinning this knight here, white is creating a lot of threats, but Pranav stays calm and steady. He's like, okay, I'll just be solid here. A4 was played, and now short castle. So black has kind of developed all his pieces. A little weirdly, the bishop is here, the knight is pinned, but everything for now is secure. Bishop went to e3, and here I think Pranav could have played better. He could have taken here. And now an interesting move, which is rook ad8. Let's say you take ab5, then there is this knight b4 move, which has to be foreseen. You attack the bishop, and you are creating threats just to unpin is the idea and create knight b4. But he played bishop b6, which is also a sensible move. Now later on the bishop won't be hanging and the rook is free to move away. Castles, rook ad8, ab, ab. And now after de5, he took d5, bishop b6, cb6. And although Pranav's structure is slightly mangled up, it's still a good position for him. No real problems. His pieces are well positioned. It's around equal. Queen e2, and now knight e7, hitting the bishop. And now starts the game in which Pranav starts to take the initiative. Also defends the b5 pawn. Here, white played queen e3. And now, bishop g4, good move. Creating some pressure here, also preparing knight g6 to f4. Rook a6 was played, and now rook came up to d6, again defending the pawn. Slowly, you can see how black starts to take the initiative. Here, Pranav could have already taken and gone into an endgame, which would have been around equal, no problems. But he is ambitious here. He sees that the tide is moving in his direction, so plays rook fd8, knight e1, and now this is not a great move. Maybe white should have continued actively with rook fa1, but after knight e1, knight g6. Now the knight is coming here or here. Also, threats on the e2 square will be created. F3, bishop went back to e6, he took, and now queen takes e6. The point is that although the pieces are getting exchanged, black's position is getting better and better. The queen can come to c4 or b3. The rook can move into the second rank, seventh rank, and also the knight can jump to f4. Meanwhile, white pieces don't really know what they are doing. G3 stopping one move, like at least knight f4 is now not possible. H5. It's typical Pranav move, creating further weaknesses in the position. Knight g2, h4. And now, in this, well, instead of h4, Pranav could have also thought about rook d2. The point is that this is not really hanging, as after queen h3, there is a mate here. You can play rook f2, but after rook d1, rook f1, rook 8 d2, and it's a mate here. So this is winning for black. Maybe stronger to go rook d2, but h4 was not a bad move. And the point is still it's the same. Like if you go and take this pawn, then after queen h3 with rook d2 coming in, it's curtains here. So queen g5 was played by Perunovic, and now Pranav goes in with rook d2. G takes h4, the queen h3, creating this threat. And he had seen, you know, this that if white goes queens g3, he has a very powerful move. Can you find it, black to play? And it also speaks about the LPDO concept, which is loose pieces drop off. You see this rook here is undefended, so he comes back, attacks it very crucially. Yes, this is an important move. He has to move the rook. He goes back. I was thinking if he could defend this b2 pawn with rook a2, but then after queen c4, again the rook is attacked and it has to move. So he anyway went rook a1. Now rook b2, the other rook is coming in. h5 was played. If you play rook ad1, then after rook takes, and queen takes c3, black is clearly pushing here. He's better. So h5. Now the knight jumped to f4. He took, pawn takes, queen takes, and you will see that the other rook joined in the party. Black. Material is even, but the activity is totally different. Rook d1, check, king h1, queen h3, h2 pawn cannot be defended, mate is coming up, so check, king here, he had to exchange the queens. And after queen takes, first pawn falls. Rook c2, threatening, by the way, a checkmate in one, so he had to go here. Second pawn falls, check. Third pawn falls, and just like that, you know, Pranav is two pawns up. His opponent resigned here because more pawns would fall, and Pranav went on to win. This was a great game, and now he's playing against Vugara Sadli, who's a very strong player for today, 25-74. We wish him all the best. Good luck, Pranav. Keep going. This is Sagar Shah signing off. Bye bye.